Hello. Hello, is this Alex? Alex?
Hi.
Yeah. And your name, Alex?
This is my name. Alex Cook is my name.
Alex Cook.
Yeah, that's right.
And it looks like you're treating this wall here. What's the story behind this here?
Well, I'm painting a mural of a couple of big faces.
Great, great.
I'm trying to make it look like they're very three-dimensional. That's sort of the goal here, is to make them look very, like they're sticking out of the wall.
Excellent, excellent.
So do you have to do anything to the wall first?
I didn't do a single thing to the wall first, because it was already painted, and so when it has paint already on it, it's like sealed. And so once it's sealed, then I can just paint right on top of it. Principle, we're talking about basically what did we hope that the mural would do, and naturally I think sort of the hope was that it would engage the students, engage the staff, that it would be interesting, that it would be beautiful, and so we were thinking about what images would do that, and then she told me that the school theme for the year is curiosity, which is a theme that I relate to a lot, and so I was trying to think of something that would just make people be curious about it. And I know that in my years as an artist, one of the things that I've noticed is that people are always very, very impressed when they see something that creates an illusion. And so I wanted to do this mural that would create an illusion of this depth. And so far it's been accurate. The kids have been asking all kinds of questions.
So what you've done so far, about what time did you start on this?
I started at about 11:30 this morning.
Okay, 11:30, and we're about 1 o'clock?
1:30.
Okay, so it's about 2 hours worth here.
Yeah, so the beginning is always quick. At the beginning is when the most progress happens. So it probably took 20 minutes for me to put the spaces, the drawing. And then it's kind of like progress gets slower and slower and slower as you go.
So do you mix your paints, or do you just buy different colors?
Well, you see, I've got basically all the colors here. And then green also, and I got some black here because I thought I was just going to be doing this in black and white, but since the wall itself it has brown and yellow in it, I decided to do it in more like a brown and white kind of thing.
So this is how you started with the by kind of outlining it with the brush.
Yeah, exactly. I kind of like make the drawing, and then it's like a coloring book for myself. And from there, I'm just filling it in, this is like a skeleton, and then I'm putting the flesh on it. You know.
What medium type of paint do you use?
Okay, this is latex house paint. So it's the kind of paint you would use just on your house, except we've got some real bright colors here. And something that people usually don't know is that even though it's house paint, you can mix it just like it was oil paint that an artist would use, and it mixes exactly the same. And you can, just with the bright, bright colors, you can make all the colors in the whole world. Like, for example, this is all sort of browns, but I made it all with the colors you see here. Really, I've only used these four colors so far: bright green, bright red, bright yellow, and white. And I've used that to make this. This, for example, that's green and red mixed together makes that.
Mm-hmm.
So you can really make any color out of it.
The important thing for these children is to see self-image.
Yep, I know what you mean.
And that's important, because when you get to certain schools, these kids don't see anything positive coming back at them. When I was going to school, I didn't think we did anything, because we never saw anything. So
yes.
Now more so, you're going to, that door is opening up for children to be able to see a positive self-image.
That's
and
right.
To see that the others have accomplished things in life
that
look like them.
Yeah. In fact, when I was making this face here, I was thinking, what am I going to do for the hair? And a little girl walked by, I think her name is Jamira. And I said, stop just a sec, because she had the perfect hair.
Yeah.
And I said, stop and look at me. And so she stopped, and I started copying.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
He's copying.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
Yeah.
Now what happens if you make a mistake?
I never do. No, the truth is I make mistakes all the time. But the thing is, this paint is very forgiving because you can, it dries in 3 to 5 minutes, and you can go right over it. So there's really no such thing as mistake. It's really easy to, like, you can see here, I gave it 3 different tries to see, you know, this was going to be too fat, this one was going to be too skinny, and so I ended up in the middle. So I'll just go right over it, you know, no big deal.
That is
great. Thank you.
So how long have you been doing this?
I painted my first mural in 1997. So I guess I've been doing it for about 16 years.
What was that of? What was your first one of?
It was a tree of life image. So it's got this big tree, and there's a city at the bottom, so it's kind of to show that the city is this enormous. It's kind of like a spiritual idea, you know, this universal tree of life that's towering over sort of our everyday lives. That was up in Northampton, Massachusetts. How long have I been an artist? Since I was a kid. Anybody else? Questions?
Let me ask you guys this. How do you feel when you look at this painting? How does it make you feel?
It makes you feel creative. That's perfect. I'm so glad.
What gives you inspiration?
I'm always watching. I'm always keep my eyes open, and I there's beauty everywhere. And to me, I'm always watching. You know, whether I'm driving down the road or on a walk or whatever, I'm always looking. And I find nature very beautiful. I find people very beautiful. But it's everywhere. So I just keep my eyes open and let myself be moved by whatever I see that is beautiful. Who knows what's going to happen when it's red and green? What color is it going to make? Pink? No, not quite. Sort of. Close. I'll show you. Here's my red. Gray, right? How do I feel about making it? Well, I feel excited, kind of like you said before. Before I start a piece of art, I always feel excited because it's an opportunity to do something good. It's an opportunity to try my best. And I always like to try my best and just see how good I can do. I never know until it's finished what exactly it's going to look like. I never did this before. I never did a face like this before, at this size. I never did it in my whole life. Mm-hmm. So this is a first for me. It's absolutely a first. So I mean, I've drawn a lot of faces and I've drawn a lot of murals, but I've never done this exact thing. So I felt excited beforehand because I thought, how's it going to come out? I hope it comes out good. Right. I counted how many bricks
you see the squares,
there
the
are
bricks,
from the
that's
side to the
is.
Side. So I made this line to show me the middle.
Yeah.
And then I knew this side was for this face and this side was for this face. And then I counted the bricks, and you can see that I made this right here to show me the middle.
Yeah.
So I could know where to put this face. And I counted down, I think, 6 to know that, because I know that the eyes are right in the middle of the face. So I counted halfway down, and I put the eyes in the middle.
Right.
Most people don't think that's true. People think the eyes are way up here, but they're not. They're right in the middle of your head. And then the bottom of your nose is halfway between your eyes and your chin. So I made this line right here. For the bottom of the nose, and the same thing is true of the mouth. So it's like half, 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 all the way down.
Yeah.
So yes, I did contribute.
We're very honored to have you do that. I think this gentleman deserves a hand of applause.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks for your interest.
Good question.
I love that question.
Good question, Jack.
Okay, so the first thing is you have to do something that you love, that you're interested in, because if you do it and you don't love it, you're gonna quit. You have to do something that you love. Find out the thing that you love. And if it's art, that's great, but then once you fall in love with something, whether it be art or sports or math or whatever, keep doing the thing that you fall in love with. The only reason why I'm good at art is because I've done it year after year after year after year. And the only thing that makes somebody keep doing something is if they enjoy it. So you gotta find something that you enjoy. And then you have to find some way to make it useful to other people. If I was just sitting in my room painting this picture, it might make me happy for a little while, but I could never make a living at it because nobody pays you to just sit in your room making pictures. So I had to find a way to make this useful to somebody else. So that's what I would say. Find something that you love and then find a way to make it useful to somebody else.
Okay, this one here, what time did you start this about?
Got in about 9 today.
9?
Yeah. I don't even know what time it is right now.
Oh, it's running about 12 o'clock, a little bit after 12.
Okay.
So, you got this one here.
Yeah, pretty much finished that left side, that left face, and did these rocks. In the late part of yesterday.
Oh, okay. I didn't catch the rocks.
Yeah. And then today I've been working on this face, and I've also been, just recently I started making it look like the wall is broken out over there.
There it is. Yeah, I see that. Yes, indeed.
So to make this color, I put in a little bit of red, a little bit of green, some black, and white. So this is 4 different colors together.
I was noticing as you were mixing, but I probably missed a step in the process. I was thinking to myself, as I'm looking at the cans, how did you keep the colors from mixing between the cans? I guess you wet the brush and got it clean first, or?
Well, I kind of don't worry about it too much. You can see, like, in here in the white, there's a little bit of colors in there. Same with the yellow, you can see there's, I got some stuff in there.
But it's predominantly yellow.
It's such a small, tiny percentage of the actual paint that's in there, that unless you get a whole lot in there, it doesn't really affect the way the mixing works. Of anything in particular, and instead of being more gray and brown, this is like all about color instead of about forms, I guess. So it's kind of like the exact opposite.
Are you trying to have lighter colors every day, or are you gradually getting darker?
Exactly. Yeah, I know, color is so cool. That color is amazing. I mean, look at them all. Look at all the different colors you can make just from 4 colors and white. And look how dark. I haven't used a bit of black here, but you can get that dark just by mixing the colors.
The 3D effect is caused by
the shadows,
yep. And knowing the lighting effect.
Yeah, making something look three-dimensional is all about having a convincing illusion of light, which is all about shadows.
Now this one really doesn't use the shadow effect, we're using the color effect.
Exactly. So they're basically using completely different ideas. One thing that's really cool to me is you can have ideas that are so totally different, but they're both about being interesting and being beautiful.
What you're going to have most of the people being inquisitive about is, well, he sure bought a lot of paint. Look at all the colors he bought. But of course, you've showed us how you mix the colors.
And it's always surprising to me to see how little paint it actually takes. Like, I only have 5 quarts of paint here. And as you can see, I haven't even used half of this can yet. And I've already painted these 2 murals, or 1.5 really. Doesn't use that much paint.
So if you're walking on this continuum, where do you find yourself stopping? Which color would you stop it?
That's such an interesting question.